Hi, this is Chris again, and that was Autumn. He's just wandered off into the other room. Now, what I'm going to do here is I'm going to set up the top of this foot, because at the minute it's not quite set up properly. I mean, I'm sure that if I pass this over to Ognod, he's going to go, "What you been doing?" and just complain, you know, because that's his job, about my amazingly inadequate rigging job I've done. But that's because he's a 3D palace rigger. He's allowed to do that, you see. Now, important things I've got to do are, let's see, I'm going to undo those temporarily. Now I'm going to attach these to them. So I'm going to take this one and this one. Now if I move over here, oops, wrong one, and connect these, you'll see they're, see, going up and down properly. Now under that, oops, want to connect this part here. Okay, the idea being obviously that I want to be able to bend this backwards and forwards if I can, like that. It's not quite linked in the right area yet, so I'm going to have to control Z, left viewport, zoom in on it, press F3, and I'm going to affect the pivot and start with the center to object and then move it up. You can see where it's going to go. It's going to go on this line here. Back in perspective. Zoom in on it. Now you can see it's actually in the right place. See? Nice little joint to that one. So now, if I just select this, you should be able to lift that entire segment up and down. Now, I want to separate off this piece here. So, I just should select it, press F4 there, and I'm going to marquee drag up like that. Now I want to grow again, just select those two, one over there, and come around, and there's one there, and click grow again. Okay, now I'm going to detach that, and that's going to be top, leg, top, pivot. Now if I go to my left viewport, you can see the top left leg pivot just there. So what I need to do is press F3 so I can see my way through it, and I want to affect my pivot only. If you send it to the object, oops, turn back on effect pivot. Wasn't quite in the right place there. And there. Okay, back in perspective. Right, now, I don't think that's linked up yet, so I'm going to have to link that to that. Okay, done. Now, I should, in theory, be able to just rotate this straight off like so. Yeah, that's moving properly. Hurrah! Okay, make sure it's undone. Now, got to link a part at the bottom to a part at the top. And I think this is our main rotational axis, which this should in turn be attached to, and it isn't. So I really need to attach this to this. So the idea being, of course, that when this moves, that will move. So let's try that. Well, almost. Almost. Let's just break those two apart again. That's the one I want to adjust. Meaning this now has to be attached to that. I think in actual fact, break that apart. Good old complexities. Let's see. It's the bottom piece. Middle piece. Okay, so there we go, starting to get this together. Now then, we don't, if I can help it, want the rest of it to rotate. We just want this leg to, so that leg rotates fine. Okay, so now I'm going to go into the front viewport. Maddeningly complicated. Now, what I want to do is I want to make a circle just about there. Rendering, I'm not going to make it renderable, but I'm going to display a render mesh. There we go. I'm going to call this the foot handle. Okay, now what I need to do is find the right piece of foot. That's it. Okay, so I'm going to link that to that. I think that's it anyway. Yeah, it is. So I'm going to link that to our foot handle. I'm going to link that to our foot handle. What this means is that if I grab our foot handle now and lift it, our entire foot will lift. Nikasa? Good. See, and we can just do that there. I don't think everything's actually linked in quite yet, though, because if we look, still got that piece there left over. Which should, I'm sure, be linked, so I'm just gonna grab that and link it into this as well. Make it a bit easier. Now then, we can put some rotation constraints on these if we want to, but it won't inherit any. So that we can just, you know, because you don't want to do that. So what I'm going to do is just check that I can rotate this. Can I rotate this? Yes, I can. Alright. So we've got our lift control. I go to my top and zoom out and work out exactly where it is. Ah, there it is. Now I'm going to build another one, and this is going to be another circle. There we go. Back in perspective. Sort of ditch that into there. Just so I can adjust my foot rotation. There we go. And for that, see. Top viewport. Get more or less centered up. And perspective, zoom out. Top three. I'm going to try and get this, oops, lined up a bit. Okay, perspective, zoom out, whoops, there we go, so I should now be able to. Yeah, that one works okay, but I don't really want those linked together, actually. Good. Or that one. Yeah, that one. There we go. That wasn't too bad, thankfully. On that one. No. Oh yeah, and another point obviously is I want to link that one to this one. Reason being, now I can lift this up and out and rotate the foot out so that when it stamps forward like that and comes down, of course bring the foot down as well, like so. There we go. So that's that little bit of rigging done there. Huzzah. Now, these are a little bit on the festive side. We don't need to be able to actually see them anyway. So let's take off the render mesh, and we'll take off the... There we go. Then I can see where they are. Okay, and that's fine. Cool. Okay, so time for a break, and then I'll see you in the next bit.